design a rectangular key for a shaft of 50 mm diameter. Diameter is given 50 mm. The shearing and crushing stresses for the key material. Shearing stress for the material 42 megapascal, and the crushing stress for the material, key material, is 70 megapascal. Okay, asking to design the rectangular key. Designing the rectangular key is nothing but we need to calculate the length, width, and thickness. Three dimensions we need to calculate. So what type of key is asking here? Rectangular key is asking here. Rectangular key. Okay. Here particularly not mentioned whether this is a tapered key or normal key like that. Only he is asked that design a rectangular key. Okay. For that reason, we are calculating the its dimension. It's a width, and this is the length. This is the length, and this is the thickness. So, according to the given parameters, whether this key is going to sustain or not, that is the question. So, sustaining or not, we are deciding. That procedure is known as a designing here. Okay. Now, first of all, if we go through one by one, designing for a rectangular key, B how much and P how much? Yesterday I given relation, empirical relation. Anybody? Width. Yesterday I think it is denoted by W.
W is equal to D by 4 and T is equal to D by 6.
Very good, very good. D by 6. So these parameters used for the rectangular key. If it is in case of square key, both are having the D by 4 values. Okay. Now D by 4, D by value how much we in 50 by 4. This is we calculate now. And the 50 by 6 is the one value. We'll get. So D by 50 by 4 how much? 50 by 4. 12.5 means for easy our convenience I'm writing as a 13 mm. Okay. And 50 by 6 how much?
8.3.
Two values we got. B as a 13 and T as a 8. Okay. Now we need a length. How much length we need to maintain? So to calculate the length, the procedure is, see here. In first case, the rectangular key is going to fail in a shearing. First case I'm considering, key is going to fail in shear. So if the key is going to fail in shear, what happens? What is the shear stress here? Shear stress is shear load by area of the shear. So what is the shear load? From this equation, shear load is shear stress into what is the area? Shear area here. Yesterday I have derived the relation.
B into area. L.
Anybody?
B into L.
Very good. B into L. Okay. Now, torque transmitted by the key. Torque transmitted by the key. Torque transmitted by the key now torque transmitted by the key by key is general equation. Torque equal force into perpendicular distance by perpendicular distance. It means this is the shaft. Okay, the key is inserted here somewhere. So because of torque carrying by the shaft, the torque is carried by the key here. Okay, how much torque is generating here? Force into its radius. Force into its radius. That is d by d. Because I am considering this equation in shear failure, so that reason shear force I am writing here. Okay, so how much we got shear force here? Sigma s into b into l into d by 2 we got. Now sigma s how much given in the problem? 42 megapascal. D value how much we got? 13. And l value how much? We don't know. That is only we need to calculate. And d value how much? 50 by 2 it is 25 equal to t. So see here, here two unknown parameters are there here. One is t value, one is the l value. Okay, so two unknown values are there. If anyone is known, easily we can calculate the one parameter, l parameter. So which one is unknown here? Torque is unknown. So see here, from this figure, how much torque is carrying by the shaft? Same torque is going to transmit into the key. It means here whatever the torque is generating on the key, that is equal to torque carrying by the shaft also, both are equal. It means torque carrying by the shaft is pi by 16 into sigma s into t cube. Okay, so what is pi by 16 into, calculate sigma s how much? 42 into 50 cube. 50 cube. Calculate it. How much? Calculate it. Torque value how much? Make it fast. What is T value?
1.03 newton meters.
1.03 into 10 power 6.
It is. Tell me in terms of kilo. Newton meter. 10.
1.03 into 10 power 3 kilonewton mm.
1.03 into 10 to the power of 3 kilonewton mm. Now if I write this one. So this is the one. See here, this torque is by the shaft. Okay, this torque is by the shaft. Now this is the torque by the key. By the key. Okay, so both are same in magnitude. Both are same because whatever the torque is carrying, this torque is transferring to the key. It means we can equate the these two things. We can equate the these two things. We can equate the torque by shaft, torque by shaft equal torque by key. Both are I am equating. So torque by shaft how much I got? 1.03 to the power of 3 equal, and torque by key how much I got? How much I got? 42 into 13 into 25. 42 into 13 into 25. With this much, 25. Okay, this much I got. Now tell me the L value. L value.
75 mm. 75.4.
7.54. Somebody given 7.54. Who's that number? Rule number 3 is given as 7.54. 75.44 or 7.54. The answer in terms of mm. Okay. Now. Okay. Now, in previous case, key is going to fail in shear. Now second case, key is going to fail in crushing. So key is going to fail in crushing means, what is crushing stress here? Crushing load by area of crushing. Now with this, what is crushing force? Crushing stress into crushing area. What is the crushing area? Anybody? What is the crushing area? Yesterday we discussed crushing area.
Now what is H by 2 into L or E by 2 into L?
T by 2 into L. Okay, this is the crushing force. Now torque transmitted by key. Torque transmitted by key. What is torque transmitted? Basic equation, T equal force into perpendicular distance. Now I am calculating this equation with the reference of crushing. See the title here, crushing. So that reason I am writing here crushing force. Okay, now with this, what is torque? Sigma c into L into T by 2 into D by 2. Okay, now what is sigma c? 70 megapascal. L value we don't know. Thickness how much you got? Thickness how much? 8 we got. 8 by 2 into 50 by 2. Okay, this is the torque transmitted by the key. Now torque transmitted by the shaft is, torque by shaft is how much we got in previous case? Torque by shaft 5 by 16 into sigma s into d2. How much we got torque by shaft? This value how much we got? 1.03 into 10 to the power of 3. Yeah. This much. So see here, there is always shear stress only we need to consider. Always we need to consider for the torque transmitted by the shaft. Please unmute yourself. Somebody is talking. Somebody is making noise. Roll number 64 is tapping with the mobile phone. Roll number 74, mute yourself. Roll number 74, mute yourself. Most of the people's while KM going, class is going on, speaking with someone. Okay, this much torque we calculated. Now, torque by shaft. So 1.03 into 10 to the power of 3 equals 70 into L into 4 into 25. So tell me the L value how much. Make it fast. This much L value we got. Now see here, at the beginning we calculated the B value, T value. T value as 8 mm, B value as 13 mm, and two L values we calculated, 75.4, 73.5. So between these two, which one is we need to select? That is the question mark. Suppose if we select the 73 value, suppose for example I am telling, if we select the selecting the for the given parameter 73.57, if I selected, Which one? Rule number one. 147 for what? 147. You got the answer. Rule number one. For what you got?
L value, sir. That is not 147. 147.14, sir. Yes, sir.
In crushing.
Yes, sir.
Somebody given the 73. So that's where I read it. How much you got? 147.4. 147.4. So see here. Now these two L values we got. So suppose if I select the 75 as a L value. So what happened? 75 is, if I select, the key is going to withstand in the shear, but not withstanding in the crushing. Because the L value for the crushing is exceeding here, more than the 75. Okay. If I select the second 147.47 value, if I select for the design is going to save under the shearing as well as in the crushing also. Okay, that is the one. So that comment you need to write. The larger value for the length is 147.47. That will going to withstand in the both shearing and crushing criteria, like that. Okay, so this is the method to calculate the dimensions. So calculating the dimensions, these calculations are give the satisfactory result based on the given parameters. Okay, this is the answer. Okay, so if you want to copy, make a copy or take a screenshot. Okay, shall we move to next problem,
sir?
Crushing means it will be going to compression, no, sir?
Yes.
Then torque is different and crushing is different, no, sir?
See here, yesterday I explained again the unit explanations here. See here. If the suppose in first case it is going to shearing, first case, when it is the when the shearing is going to happen, when the material is lesser in strength. Okay. If it is the material by observation, what you did, the material strength you are going to increases. So for that reason, what happened? This key material is going to not fail in a shear. Okay. Now because what happened? The key is continuously under operation when the system is rotating, means whenever the shaft is rotating, means in the engine, when you are changing the gears, what happens when you are changing the gears, applying the clutch and applying the gears. So when you are releasing the clutch plates, what happened? Impact loads are going to apply on the shafts. Okay. That impact loads are going to act through the shaft on the key material. Okay, so because of continuous application of this impact load, there may be some crushing of the material like this. There may be crushing of the material. Why I'm drawing here? Because half portion is going to mounted in the shaft. This half portion is going to sitting in the shaft. The above half portion is going to sitting in the hub of the gear or hub of the pulley and hub of the another any type of devices. Okay, hub means suppose this is the gear. Okay, this is the gear. Whatever the portion appearing here with the hole, somewhat thickness it is having here. Okay, this portion called as a hub. To this hub, there is a one slot is providing here. Here, with darkly, I am drawing here. Okay. So, one slot is providing. This slot is for providing the keyway mounting. Okay. The above half portion is going to sit in this key, and bottom portion is going to sit in this Okay, whenever the gear is rotating because of releasing of the clutches, okay, the gear is going to subjected to the impact loads. Okay, that impact loads are going to applied through this gear, through the shaft. Here it is going to apply. So that reason, because of continuous application of the impact, the gear, this key material is going to subjected to the crushing. After some time, what happen after this crushing? There will be a looseness between the shaft and this gear. Between these two meeting parts, there will be a looseness. Because of looseness, what happen? Some noises and the misalignments are going to be generated while it is operating. Okay. Now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
This is the second question. This is the second question. Given data first. For the long answer question, you can expect such type of question. But while giving the long answer question, A question, B question, like that. In that manner, the questions will be given. Okay? Because these are small problems. The 45 mm diameter of the shaft. Diameter of the shaft is given 45 mm. It is made of steel. Okay? With a yield strength. Yield strength is given as 400 megapascal. Yield strength means whenever there is no mention of any speciality, means yield strength, like simply they given the yield strength, that represents the yield strength in tensile. Particularly when it is going to mention yield strength in shear, at that time you need to write here like this, yield strength in shear. When there is no mentionity here, so at that time directly you need to consider yield strength in tensile or directly. Okay, and the parallel key, the parallel key here, it is given the parallel key. Okay, parallel sanki key is given of a size 14 mm wide. B value is given as 14 mm. Okay, and the thickness value is given as 9 mm. Okay, made of these also made of steel. Yield strength tensile of 340 megapascal. Now see here also one yield strength is given, here also one yield strength is given. This yield strength for the shaft. Okay, this yield strength for the key. Okay, find the required length. Question is given, find the required length of the key. If the shaft is loaded to transmit the maximum permissible torque, okay, use maximum shear stress theory. By using maximum shear stress theory. Okay, according to by using this theory, we need to calculate the length of the key. Okay, now according to the maximum shear stress theory, is yield in direct strength by 2 into factor of safety. According to this theory, yield strength is maximum tensile strength is half into factor of safety. Okay. Now what is maximum shear stress theory? Maximum yield strength. Now I'm calculating for this key, and I'm calculating for this value for shaft. For both values. First of all, for key I am calculating. So yield strength for the PA material, how much given? 340 by 2 into factor of safety. Factor of safety is given. In given data, there is no factor of safety. Okay, sorry. The question is given factor of safety.
Factor of safety 2, sir.
In question it is given. Okay. Factor of safety is 2. Now, what is the maximum permissible shear stress for the key material? It is. Okay, 85. 85. Similarly, calculate maximum shear stress theory for the shaft material 400 by 2 into 2. So it is 2 to the 400 megapascal for shaft. Okay. Now, torque transmitted by the shaft. No, torque transmitted by the shaft. Torque transmitted by the shaft. What is the equation? P is equal to pi by 16 into shear stress maximum into d cube. Okay. So here pi by 16 sigma is for the shaft, we calculated 100, dq is 40, 45 cube. So y by 16 into 100 into 45, that is the term. Okay, question, what is mentioned? The question is, the shaft is loaded to transmit maximum permissible torque. How much maximum permissible torque is not given here. So that we calculated here, maximum permissible torque. How much you got? One point seven nine into ten to the power of six newton mm. This much we got. Now, torque transmitted by the key, in crushing as well as in shear. In both criteria, we need to calculate. While we are calculating in crushing, we will get the length value. While we are calculating in shearing, we will get the one length value. Compare these two lengths. Compare these two lengths. Which one is having the maximum? That one we need to select. Okay. Now, torque transmitted by key in shearing. In shearing consideration, okay. So, what is torque transmitted by shaft here? Key force into perpendicular distance vector. Because I'm considering the shearing, here I'm right to, I need to write shear force. How much shear force? The shear force you can maximum permissible shear stress for the key is shear force by area, shear area. So from this relation, you will get the shear maximum permissible into what is the area B into L. Okay. Now that is torque equal maximum permissible shear stress into B into L into D by 2. So maximum permissible shear stress, how much you got? How much for the key material? 85 megapascal we got. 85 megapascal into B value, how much given in the data? D value 14 mm. D value as a 14, L value we don't know, D value how much given? D 45 by 2, D value 45 by 2, that is the T. How much the value? 1.7 into 10 to the power of 6, 1.7 into 10 to the power of 6 equal 85 into 40 into length into 45 by 2. Now tell me the L value. Somebody got the 65. Calculate properly. Don't get the variations in calculation. Calculate properly. Make it proper.
So 63.49, sir.
63.49. Somebody is 66.81 given. The actual answer is, wait, I'm seeing 60. How much is the answer? 67.2. The answer should. The answer is 67.2. Most of the people getting 63.49. Okay. 63.49 mm. Now torque transmitted by
If we take into 10 power 3, we are getting 65.7, sir.
You need to take into consideration.
10 power 6 point, If we take 10 power 3, we are getting 65.
Into 10 to the power of 3, if you are right here, you will get, you are getting 65.
Yes, sir.
What happened if you select the 10 to the power of 6?
It's
63.
Getting
66. 66 is the correct one.
No, sir, it's getting 63.49.
63.49 only, sir.
63.49.
Whatever I have written on the screen, as it is substituted in the calculator and tell me the answer.
Yes, sir. We are getting 63.49 only, sir.
Okay. Now torque transmitted by key in crushing. So in crushing, crushing force into du by 2. Crushing stress equal crushing force by, sorry, crushing force into d by 2. Okay, what is crushing force? Sorry. Crushing force by crushing area. Now crushing force equal crushing stress into area. What is the area here? Area is L into T by 2. What is crushing force here again? Crushing stress how much? Crushing stress. Is it given in the problem? See, crushing stress.
340.
Yield strength for the key, yield strength for the shaft is given. For the key, yield strength, crushing stress is not given. Okay. So remember the relation. Crushing strength. Okay, maximum crushing strength for the key material is yield strength by 2. Yield strength by 2, not factor of safety. Okay. Only just by 2 I am adding it. Removing, if you remove the factor of safety, that represents a crushing value. Okay, remember this relation. Now torque transmitted by the shaft by the key is crushing force into d by 2. Crushing force is yield strength in tensile by 2 into length into thickness. How much given in the problem? Thickness as a 9, thickness as a 9 by 2 into 45 by 2. So this torque is 1.7. Already I calculated 1.7 into 10 to the power of 6 equal. How much this one yield strength value for the key? Yield strength for the key 340. Yield strength for the key is 340 by 2 into L into 9 by 2, 4.5 into 45 by 2. 20 point from how much? 45 by 2. Tell me the L value in mm. L value 103.9 mm. Is it right for all? If everybody got the same answer, then this L value due to crushing is right, 103.9. Okay. For the maximum permissible torque, based on the maximum permissible torque.
Sir, it's coming 98.76, sir.
98.76. Okay. So is it right for all? 98.76. 98.76. The answer should be, this is the one correct one, I think. This is the not one. 98.76. We check it properly again. The answer is, actual answer is 104.6. But you are getting somewhat less value. So maybe this is a good, better, but you need to check this one. Okay. So see here, maximum question is mentioned by considering the maximum permissible torque. So here, based on considering the maximum permissible torque, here also maximum permissible torque. So this maximum permissible torque, where we calculated here in previous case, here. In previous case, this is the maximum permissible torque we calculated. Okay, based in this maximum load or permissible torque, we calculated the length value. So in both cases, suppose here you may get 103 or 98. In both cases, length of the key in crushing is larger value, crushing only, not in shear. So for that, whichever, suppose in shear, if you get the larger value, select the shear value as a length. If you get the larger value in case in crushing, select the larger value in crushing. So that statement you need to write, the larger value of the key length is 103 or 98.76. Okay, that will give the satisfactory results for the safe design. Okay, this is the another problem. So make a copy or take a screenshot. Last 5 minutes are there, okay. We'll take attendance. Any doubts regarding, you can ask. Do you have any doubts regarding this one? We can ask. One more problem is there with this. You can complete the total this topic. So wait for 10 minutes. Okay. Small problem. It is required to design a square key. Okay. Design a square key. Design a square key. Okay. Design a square key. For fixing on a gear, and shaft. Here, where it is using, where we are using the key, gear and shaft. okay, of 25 mm diameter of the shaft. The shaft is transmitting the 15 kilowatts power. First, write the given data. Given data. How much given data? So power is given as 15 kilowatts of power. Its speed is given 720 rpm, and diameter of the shaft is given as 25 mm, and key is made up of 50 C4 steel grade with the yield tensile strength. Yield tensile strength as 460 megapascal or newton per meter square. Factor of safety is given as 3. For key material, yield strength for key material is relation is given. Yield strength in compression can be assumed to equal in yield tensile strength. Yield strength in compression is equal to yield strength in tensile. This relation is given. It means whatever the value is given, 460, that is also equal for the compression, okay, and can be assumed equal. Determine the dimensions of the key. What is the dimensions? B value, T value, and L value.
Sir, yield strength and crushing strength are same. Sorry, compression strength and crushing strength are same, sir.
These two are same. That is given in the question, not I am writing. Yield strength.
Sir, so, matlab I am asking. Compression strength and crushing strength are same.
Compression strength and
crushing.
Both are same. When it is subjecting to compression, then only it is going to crush. Here, whatever the yield strength is given, that yield strength, your quotient data is given equal to the compression. That is compression is nothing but crushing strength. Crushing, compression, both are same meaning. Okay. So here you need to calculate the B value, T value, because this is a square key. For the square key, width and thickness both are same. That is D/4. So how much d value 25 mm by 4. How much this one? 25 by 4 6.25. It means directly I'm writing 6 mm. Okay, d value both are 6 mm. Now length value only we need. Okay, now according to the maximum shear stress theory, maximum shear is yield in tensile by 2 into factor of safety. Yield in tensile into 2 into factor of safety. So yield strength of for the key, how much given? 460 by 2 into factor of safety 3. So how much this one? 76.67 megapascal. Okay, now torque transmitted by key, okay, in shear failure I'm considering. So how much this one torque? Directly I'm writing here, torque equal shear maximum shear into length into d into d by 2. Okay, now maximum shear how much got? 76.67. L value we don't know, d value we got as a 6. D by 2, d have as 25 by 2. 25 by 2 means 12.5. okay, t. Now t, what is the t value here? T is the torque transmitted by the torque carrying by the shaft and torque transmitted by the key, both are equal. Okay, So torque transmit, torque carrying by the shaft, we need to calculate separately. So general equation, you know, pi by 16 into sigma s into dq. Okay. So with this relation, we can calculate. But shear stress for the shaft material is not given in the question. Shear stress for the shaft material is not given in the question. So for that, another, if you go through the given data, power, speed values is given. So power relation, what is the power relation? Power transmitted, power from the shaft is 2 pi n t by 60. This is the relation. Power carrying capacity for the shaft material, this is the equation in a watts. Okay, now you can find the torque here. Okay. Now write it the torque modified equation P into 60 by 2 pi n. P value is given 15 kilowatts into 10 to the power of 3 into 60 by 2 into pi into n value is given 720 rpm. 720 rpm. What is torque here? Calculate torque. Calculate the torque. Make it fast.
198.94
is the torque. So making this torque is equal to this. So 198.9 equal 76.67 into L into 6 into 12.5. So what is the L value here? What is the L value here? What is the L value? Calculate L value, same manner. Same manner. Torque transmitted key in crushing directly. I'm writing the equation P equal crushing maximum stress into L into T by 2 into D by 2. This represents the crushing force. Okay, directly I'm writing. So maximum compression, how much given? Maximum compression is given as in the relation. Maximum compression is equal to yield tensor as a 460. As a 460 into L into thickness, how much given? Thickness 6 we got. Thickness as a 6, thickness 3, 12.5. How much torque we got? Torque is 198.9. So tell me the L value. Okay. In terms of tell me the L value by considering the crushing. Tell me the L value by considering the shearing. By considering the shearing. Between.
Sir, the first. First L value is coming at
0.034.
Yes, sir.
Next one. This is you are getting the meters. Tell me in mm. Mm means 34. The second one is.
No, sir. By substituting the
second
same.
One is 7.53 mm, sir.
Sir, by substituting the same data, I am getting the 0.034.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you are saying in the meters. So value. Wait. You have to say it in
here, this is the Newton meter. Newton meter is the one, because What is the units of the watts? Joules per second. Joules per second means Newton meter per second. Here is the meter. Whatever the torque we got, that is the Newton meter. Newton meter. So meter value are substituting here. So the answer also will come in meters. If we convert it to mm, it should be 34 mm.
Yes, sir. 34.58 mm.
Okay. Now for this one, in crushing.
11.53 mm.
7.53 mm.
11, sir. 11.53.
11.53. So which one is the highest value here? 34 is the highest value. Means 34 length we need to consider. The larger value is for length.
But in the question he asked to determine the dimension of the key, no sir.
No, wait. Larger value of the length is 34 we got. L. Okay. Now B value we calculated, we got 6. P value we calculated, we got 6. L value now only we calculated as a 34. Okay. 6, 6. Because it's a square key, both sides having the 6 and 6. Only the length is 34. Only the length is 34. Is it right? This is the dimensions. So it is required to design the square key. So designing the square key, nothing but calculating the safe dimensions. For the given parameter, these safe dimensions will going to give the same safe results. Okay. Any doubts regarding today's problem, you can ask. Otherwise, I will end the meeting.